It's not my fault. Book the kid with the keyboard.
Postal. Yeah, we're talking about Postal again. Last time I did, it was about the terrible, horrible, no good, very bad Postal 3, and how it nearly made me lose my sanity. But this time, we're looking at another Postal game. And that game... is Postal Brain Damage. Well, the demo, at least. Yeah, you thought I was gonna be talking about Postal 4, didn't you? Ha! Postal Brain Damage is a spinoff taking the series into a skill-based retro shooter direction, or as some would call it, a boomer shooter. Some example of other boomer shooters are Ultra Kill, Dusk, Quake, and our very own Postal 2. But what makes this game differ from its edgier older brother, Postal 2, is that this game is fucking fast! Hey, what's up, boys? Future Jamie here. And shortly after I made this little quip about Postal Brain Damage being fucking fast, I went back into Postal Brain Damage because I wanted to see how fast I could actually beat it. I was able to beat the first level in a minute 29, with the current world records being 26 seconds with glitches and 44 seconds without glitches. I wasn't fucking lying when I said this game was fast. And isn't an open world game, instead functions on a level by level system. You could still piss, though. So, what about the story of Postal Brain Damaged?
What fucking moron designed this?
Well, there isn't one, really. The game is still in early development, so the story isn't even set in stone. However, I do have an early, leaked script of the story sent to me by an anonymous source.
You're gonna burn, all right.
This story takes the Postal franchise into a bold new direction. And at first, I didn't even think it was real. But please keep an open mind when I tell you the early proposed story. The story opens up on a Wednesday. Postal dude watching the popular anime series, Neon Genesis Evangelion. God. Then has a time skip to the next day, where it shows him watching the credits to the movie, End of Evangelion. There's another time skip to Sunday, where it shows him watching the credits to Evangelion 3.0 plus 1.0, implying he's watched every rebuild of Evangelion movie. The Postal dude, racked with so many feelings, goes into an Evangelion-induced schizophrenic depression, where he then commits an Oscar reference and goes into a coma. While in the coma and fears someone is going to replicate that hospital scene in End of Evangelion, the Postal dude sets out to fight his way through his coma in his own fucked up brain. We'll then see him in the white void, where he tells us his version of the opening because he's too afraid to admit he likes Evangelion, then gets sucked into the first level.
Gee, I hope nobody is taping this.
I would best describe Postal Brain Damage's gameplay and level design.
I didn't expect that.
Is basically, you take Ultra Kill and you take Postal 2 and you give them a weird one-night stand where nothing makes sense and it's really fast and it's really disgusting and you get Postal Brain Damage. So because this is a demo, we only have one level in the game, the neighborhood. The neighborhood is actually a really good choice for a demo level. It's very open, has pretty good level design, and I would assume introduces a good amount of the gameplay features. The level features a good amount of secrets like a grenade launcher, a portal with some helpful items, and... however, I will say there's one major downside to the level that it's kind of lying to you. See, when you walk in the street, you see all these houses, and when I first saw this, I thought, oh man, I bet there's so many secrets in so many of these houses.
What are you, stupid?
There are about four different preset house interiors, and none of those houses actually have anything of worth in them.
Your life is nothing. You serve zero purpose. should kill yourself now.
I don't know if this was done to improve playtime or to replicate Postal 2's open world aspect in this linear shooter, but hey, for most people this probably isn't an issue. However, for someone like me who has a stupid desire to collect everything in a video game, this is kind of annoying. This level also matches quite well with the gameplay. The gameplay really matches that boomer shooter flair the game has. It has your typical fast movement and side-strafing action that most boomer shooters have. However, this game has a forbidden fruit of the genre, if you will. Slide jumping. If you want to go fast enough to see God, slide jumping is your friend. Now, with you being able to hold down spacebar to continuously jump, it makes slide jumping, personally, my prime way of moving around in this game. In this demo, there are a total of 5 weapons that are featured. The first one you'll encounter is the shovel, the flagship melee weapon of the game, allowing the player to easily saw away at enemies and reflect projectiles. The smart pistol, a standard pistol that has a feature that locks on to nearby enemies' weakest areas. And honestly, it kind of sucks.
This is terrible.
The thing doesn't do enough damage to really warrant its major usage, especially after you get the shovel, and especially after you get the super shotgun. The super shotgun is basically a one-to-one copy of the super shotgun from Doom Eternal, hook and all. The super shotgun in this game is just so satisfying to use. And the major difference between this game's and Doom Eternal's Super Shotgun is that in Postal brand damage, it's much faster to use. And with the mass amount of ammo you can hold, it never feels like you're gonna run out of ammo with it. Also, there's the secret weapon, the rocket slash grenade launcher. It's fine. I've never really been a rocket or grenade launcher kind of guy in most games, because usually they're slow or have drop-off shots and it annoys the fuck out of me. But it's kind of different in this game. The rockets are fast and the grenades do have a drop-off, but they fire so fast and have a charge-up shot to them that you'll never really notice this. Now, your next weapon is the weapon of mass destruction. The one thing that will make enemies quiver and shake in their boots, make them even question going up against the feared Postal Dude. And that weapon is...
This was a triumph. I'm making a note here. Huge success.
Overall, the weapon selection in the demo is quite good, and I'm excited to see what other weapons are in store. Along with that, there are 2 items the player can use. The pipe makes its return from Postal 2, and does the same thing as in that game, kind of. It gives the player an instant health boost, however in Postal 2, when the player took it, eventually it would start to harm the player unless they used another one after a while. As far as I can tell, this isn't in the game, and honestly, I kind of want that. I love risk-reward systems games, and if this was in it, it would make players really question if they want to use the pipe, with the risk of them not being able to find another one in the level. There's also the hot sauce that makes your piss turn into fire. Yes, you heard me right. Your piss comes out as literal fire, and it is as funny as it sounds. Now, what's a video game without some really good music? And God, the music in this game makes me feel like I'm about to fight God. Of course, because this is a fast-paced action shooter game, it's gonna have the funny metal music, and just like others, it sounds fucking spicy as hell. Now, me talking about it can't show it the justice that it deserves, so I'm just gonna let you listen to it while I show some of my shitty gameplay. Will Postal Brain Damage be a good game? Well, look at the thumbnail of the video. This game has amazing potential to sit up there with the greats of modern retro shooters, but also, like every game, has the potential to be really, really shit.
Don't be like Postal 3.
But judging by the fact that this game has the studio behind the original games running with scissors, backing the game and helping with development, I think we'll be in good hands. Postal has always been a series I've loved very, very much, even when I was a kid. So seeing this franchise go into a genre of games I love makes me really happy, and I will 100% be pre-ordering this the moment I can. Thank you all for watching. This is the first time I've done a video like this with an actual script and me having words planned of what I have to say. This is what I want to make now, and yeah, I haven't uploaded a real fucking video in about 6 months. But once I get the ball rolling on this, videos will start coming out sooner. Once again, thank you all for sitting here and listening to me ramble for minutes. Like, subscribe, do all the other shit all the other YouTube fuckers tell you to do, and I'll see you in another 6 months with, Doom Iceberg 2. I swear it's coming out. I swear.